Thank you and welcome to Digitally Open. Thank you to all our esteemed speakers for coming today, and special thank you to our partner in this event, Creative Commons. They have been truly invaluable in helping develop this amazing program. I look forward to continuing our conversation tomorrow as we begin the important work of porting a Creative Commons license to Alan. This license will promote the creation of original digital content in the Arab world while protecting the rights of the content's creator. I see this as an important step in our effort to create a truly digitally open society in Qatar. The openness is key for Qatar development, a thriving knowledge-based society. Openness means collaboration, it means transparency, it means sharing, it means innovation. To this end, I believe digital openness across all sectors is essential into being a global leader for the future. Of course, this event is a big step. However, it's just a first step. At ICT Qatar, we are committed to going beyond this event and action to develop an open ecosystem in which digital content and innovation thrive. Already you are seeing tangible results from local companies that take advantage of open practice. Al Jazeera is the most prominent example with its bold decision to make much of its content available under Creative Commons license. Sharing footage from events such as Gaza has provided a different perspective on world events. As a result, the Al Jazeera brand has expanded and strengthened globally. Al Jazeera serves as a tremendous model. ICT Qatar is also in the process of developing a national digitization plan to preserve Qatar's national heritage and share it with the world. There is a wealth of information on Qatar. On Qatar's history, print, photo, and film format that should be digitized. There are also abundance of valuable documents in Arabic that need to be brought to a wider audience. Digitization of these materials will allow them to reach a whole new generation, and of course, these materials should be made open to the public without restriction. And as we share our content openly, we will also be promoting the development of open internet standards, especially in terms of accessibility. Digital content is only valuable if people can access it, and too often people with disability are left behind. Enabling them to use the internet and participate in open ecosystem means more people to create and innovate. To this end, ICT Qatar is exploring working with the World Wide Web Consortium to develop comprehensive accessibility standard in Arabic. The effort will be led by MENA, Qatar Assistive Technology Center, which is also working to energize the open source community around developing and Arabizing software and technology that can benefit people with disability. I encourage other government agencies, the private sector, and non-profit organizations to find a way to help grow this ecosystem. In the education field, for example, it would be hugely valuable to openly share education sources as recommended by UNESCO. In the medical community, researchers may be able to find cures for diseases if they work remotely with peers around the world as opposed to rushing individuals to work effectively. In many cases, being open can even be considered a moral obligation. I would also encourage each of you, especially to make commitment to openness. When I look out in the audience, I am excited about the potential this country has had. I see a lot of young faces here, and it does not come as a surprise because 65% of the Arab population are less than 25 years old. They are the people that will benefit the most from open digital world. Right now, ICT Qatar is working and study that explores in Europe how technology is impacting Qatariya.
And while we are still in the early stages of conducting that excited research, it's no surprise that technology has a profound effect in how our youth communicate, think, and interact. The younger generation is full of ideas, full of energy, full of passion. Understanding and embracing openness will create an environment in which our young people can flourish and not feel stifled by outdated practices and models. And in creating an environment that truly supports global collaboration and innovation, we will be creating unique competitive advantage over markets that don't promote digitally open society. And this will help attract big thinkers and bold new companies. I am confident that our effort will help us create truly open digital ecosystem in Qatar and encourage other countries in the region to follow our lead. The Arab world has a strong and important voice that must be heard. Embracing a digitally open world that will put all the front innovation and help propel us toward being a knowledge-based economy. I thank you all for coming and hope that today's event will inspire you to become part of that digitally open society. It depends on all of us. Thank you.